Dear friends, welcome to my new video. In the previous project, I presented you how to use this transistor as touch sensor transistor, but today I will present you something interesting with this transistor and 555 timer. Today I will present you how to make a simple DC to DC converter using this transistor and 555 timer. First of all, we need two of these capacitors. This Schottky diode. This electrolytic capacitor. This wire inductor. This transistor. The 555 timer. Then, I suggest you to don't use your Arduino multimeter because you don't know the voltage of the output, but I will use this multimeter. This is my brand old multimeter because I have three of these devices and one analog multimeter, but today I promise to use this multimeter and I see that it works. But now in 20 kilo ohms. You need two of these resistors. This resistor. Okay, I turned in 2 kilo ohms resistor. You need your cell phone charger, one cell phone charger. I use this wire. This is the 5 volts power supply and this is the ground for the circuit. Then I will use some of these wires. Now let's build it. Then I will put in the transistor in the breadboard. Okay. Now let's measure the pins. Pin 1, pin 2, pin 3, pin 4, pin 5, sorry, pin 5, pin 6, pin 7, and pin 8. At first, the pin 1 is the ground. Then I will shortcut the pin 2 with the pin 6. Then I will connect this capacitor between pin 2 and ground, which is the pin 1. Pin 8 is the power supply, so I will connect this resistor, this 4.7 kilo ohms resistor, between pin 6 and pin 7. Then the other resistor between pin 7 and P8, which is the power supply. Here we made something such as a potentiometer, which this pin is the power supply, the pin 8. This pin is the pin 7, and this pin is the pin 2 or pin 6. Okay, let's continue. Okay, I confused. This is the 0.22 nanofarads capacitor, which we will connect it between pin 5 and VCC power supply, pin 5 and pin 8. Okay, I connected and the USB for power supply, but now I will ground the emitter of the transistor. Then I will use the 2022 ohms resistor between pin 3 and base. I connected the wire inductor between collector, as you can see, and power supply. The cathode is the output, but now let's see the results. We can see that the converter works fine. So here you can control your output voltage with this coil wire inductor. Okay, this wire inductor has as output 23.7 volts. Okay, project works. Now, without the capacitor, we can see these waves in the oscilloscope. In 25 volts. But now let's test it with this capacitor. Now with the capacitor we can see that we now if we power it off, we have a slow voltage drop. Circuit still works. And now the voltage is equal to zero. Nice. Okay, as you can see, I bring in my second voltmeter to test the circuit again, for sure. But now, let's test in the oscilloscope. Okay, we can see that this is the wave with the capacitor. Okay, I hope that you like my video. Don't forget to subscribe in my channel, and if you have any questions about this project, please send me in the comments. See you in my next video!